Come back. In this video, we are going to solve example 8.6 that is taken from chapter number 8, Combined Loading, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbler, and it's 9th edition. So statement of the problem is the solid rod shown in figure 8-7a has a radius of 0.75 inch. If it is subjected to the force of 800 pound, determine the state of stress at point A. So you can see this is a circular, solid circular rod that is acted upon by a vertical force 800 pound in the direction of Z, clear. So due to this load of 800 pound, you have to determine the state of stress at point A, that what are the stresses acting at point A. So let's start with the solution. So first step is that if you cut this rod at point A and draw the free body diagram, I have drawn it over here. So you can see that there is 800 pound that force is acting downward, clear. So in order to balance this force at this point A, so there will be a vertical reaction force, or V will be applied in the direction of Z. And you can see that this 800 pound into perpendicular distance of 1400 will also produce a counterclockwise rotation at point Y, or about Y axis. So in order to balance it, we have a clockwise movement at point above Y axis, which will be MY. So I will write it over here that here it will be having MY. And due to this 800 pound into perpendicular distance is this one, which is 10 inch. So it is also producing clockwise movement in about X axis. So in order to balance it, we must have anti-clockwise movement, which will be MX. So I will represent a movement about X axis will be MX. Now we'll find this V, M, Y and X by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is sum of all forces along Z direction must be equal to zero, and upward force is taken as positive. So V is acting upward. So V minus this 800 pound that is acting downward will be equal to zero. So it means that V is equal to 800 pound. Now we will find this MY by using another equation of equilibrium, and that is sum of all movement about Y axis must be equal to zero, taking the counterclockwise movement as positive. So you can see MY, which is acting clockwise, that is negative, multiply by 800 into perpendicular distance is 14, and this is producing counterclockwise movement. This will be positive and their sum must be equal to zero. So I can write minus MY plus 800 into 14 is equal to zero. So it means that MY will be equal to 800 into 14 will be equal to 11200 pounds into inch. So this is MY. Similarly, we can find MX by using another equation of equilibrium, that is sum of all movement about X axis must be equal to zero, taking the counterclockwise movement as positive. So above X axis, MX is counterclockwise, which is reaction movement. So MX and about this X axis, this perpendicular distance is 800 and this vertical force is 800 and perpendicular distance is 10 inch, and this is producing clockwise movement, so it will be negative. So I can write minus 800 multiplied by 10 is equal to zero. So from here we will get this MX will be equal to 8000 pounds into inch. Okay. Now we have seen that we have V is equal to 800 pound there, and MY is 11200 pounds into inch, and MX is 8000 pounds into inch. So we will see that due to this vertical force at this cross section will be having shear force due to this movement MY, which will produce torsion effect at this cross section, and due to this MX we will have a bending movement. So we will write these forces one by one. So starting from, I will write stress components. So starting with first one was what shear force V. So shear force V will produce shear stress, and we will see that this shear stress will be equal to tau of YZ. How? You can see that this is x-axis and this is z-axis. Here you can see x-axis and z-axis, and it is making y-plane. Clear? And tau of yz means that it will produce shear stress in this y-plane and in the direction of z. So this will be in, on this cross-section, we will be having tau of yz. Okay. So we'll find this tau of yz. So we will see that this tau of yz is at, since we are finding it at point A, so tau of yz is equal to V into QA divided by I about x-axis, this shear force is VQ divided by I into thickness T. Okay, now what is V force? So you can see V is 800 pound, clear? And what is QA? So for that, I will, if I take this circle and draw the cross section over here. So if this is the circular rod, this is its x-axis and this is its z-axis. Clear? And this is your point A. So A lies on the centroidal axis or neutral axis. So we will take this area, this shaded area. So we know that y dash is equal, QA is equal to y dash bar into A dash. So this will be A dash. Now what is y dash bar? So y dash bar is equal to, this is the formula, that y dash bar is equal to 4 over 3 pi into R, and A dash is equal to, it is semicircle, so it will be pi by 2 R power R square. So you have the value of R. So R is given as 0.75 inch. So I can write 4 over 3 pi into 0.75 multiply by pi by 2 into 0.75 whole square. Okay. Now, what we will get is QA. So put the value of QA, that will be 800. And from here, if you calculate it, QA will be equal to 0.2813 inch power cube. Okay. So 0.2813 divided by, and I for this circular shaft will be equal to pi by 4 C power 4. Okay, so pi by 4 C power 4, C is 0.75 power 4, multiply by thickness. So you can see thickness will be this diameter. So that will be 2R. So multiply by 2, multiply by 0.75 inch. And when you solve this, you will get shear stress in y plane in the direction of z at point A comes out to be 604 psi, or you can say that shear stress in y plane in the direction of z at point A comes out to be 0.604 psi. So this is the shear stress due to the vertical shear force. Now we will calculate the bending stress, bending moment, which is Mx, produces bending stresses, bending stress, which will be equal to sigma in the direction of y. Clear? And we can find this sigma y will be equal to Mx into y divided by Mx into in the direction of z, because you can see this moment is this one, and y is direction from the toward the z axis will cause to produce the stresses in y direction. So I can write it mx into z divided by my divided by I. Bending stress is equal to my divided by I minus my divided by I. Or you can see bending stress is equal to m into c divided by I. Since we are finding, you can see that this is the bending moment. Since we are finding the stress at point A, you can see point A is this one. So y is distance from neutral axis till top or bottom. So here this z value will be equal to zero because A points lies on the neutral axis. So if you put z is equal to zero, so mx multiplied by zero divided by I will give you zero bending stress at point A. Rest, if you want to find the bending stress at top and bottom, it will not zero, it will having maximum value, but you can see that there will be a positive or negative value over here. Now what we will do is that we will third find the shear stress due to torsion, which will be due to this my, that is my. And we know that shear stress at point A will be again, this will be y in the direction of z, and that will be equal to t into c divided by g, and here this moment will be equal to torque there. So we can write t into c divided by j. So torque t or moment my is 11,200 pounds into inch. So 11,200 multiplied by c is distance from center till point A, which is radius. So we see 0.75 divided by j. J is the polar moment of inertia, and for circular rod it is equal to pi by 2 c power 4. So c is 0.75 power 4. So when you calculate it, you will get it 16901 psi, or shear stress in the direction in y plane in the direction of z will be equal at point A will be equal to 16.90 ksi. Okay, now you can see that all these shear forces or moments is on this portion, on this section. Clear? So if you take this section, so shear force here will be at this side will be downward, this moment will be in clockwise direction, and this will be counterclockwise direction, the opposite to which, for example, if this is the second section like this, so this shear force will be downward, this moment will be in counterclockwise, and this moment will be in clockwise direction. So if I draw this section like this, for example, if this is the circle, clear, and if I take it like this, so this is, for example, x-axis and this is z-axis. So shear force in the direction of z, this is z-axis, this is x-axis. So shear force will be in this direction. Clear? The moment about this x-axis will be clockwise. This will be mx. And moment about this y-axis, this is y-axis. So its moment will be in counterclockwise direction my. And now we will find that this is equal to, if you take only the shears, vertical shear force along z direction, so it's shear due to this vertical shear force, the stress distribution will be, this is your x-axis where you have point A and A dash. So due to this shear stress V, clear, so we have shear flow, and this shear flow will start from here, these points, and it will be maximum at point A. So this is the shear flow or shear stress due to only vertical shear force. So I can write shear force causes shear stress. And this shear stress is actually equal to 0.604 psi tau of yz at A. Okay. Plus, if you take this bending stress, so what will be the stress distribution? So it will be like this. For example, this is the cross section. And if you have only this mx, so due to mx, this is the neutral axis A dash, A and A dash. So you can see that this stress will be maximum at this point. It will be, the top one will be in tension, clear, and bottom one will be in compression. And at neutral axis or at point A, the shear force will be equal to zero. So bending stress will be equal to zero. Sigma A will be equal to zero. And this is the stress distribution due to bending moment Mx. Mx. And the last case is due to this My, which will cause torsional effect. So if I draw a circular section, so it will be like this, clear. And we can say that this is its A dash, A dash. And the shear stress, you can see here, it is like this on this section, clear. So it will produce shear stress. So shear stress distribution, this is the center. So at point A, it will be maximum. And at center, it will be equal to zero, because you can see if C is equal to zero, so shear stress at point C or center will be equal to zero. So this distribution will be like this one, clear. Now, what if I can write it, if you want to find the state of stress at point A, so what we will do is that we will use superposition. So what is superposition? So total shear stress in y plane, then direction of z at point A is due to this, which is 0.604, plus this stress, which is 116.90 KSI at point A. 116.90 KSI. So if you add them up, you will get the total shear stress at point A in y plane in the direction of z comes out to be 17.5 KSI, clear. And if you want to have the representation of this shear stress on element at point A, so this stress will be like this. On top portion, it will be like this. And same is the case for this. If you want to find the state of stress on element, differential element, so this stress distribution will be like this. It will be in downward direction. Clear? But overall state of stress on the element at point A will be equal to this one, which will be 17.5 KSI. The downward one will be the topward one. And this shear stress tau of yz at point A comes out to be 17.5 KSI. So this was all about this example 8.6. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learning from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.